Hello all my dear students. Today we are going to see lesson number 3 of physics. Name of the lesson is force. Today we are going to see activity. Aim: to find out which of the given surfaces offers the most friction. Which of the given surfaces offers the most friction? So here different types of surfaces will be taken, like smooth surface, rough surface. Okay, so you better know that friction is going to be less when the surface is smooth, and friction is going to be more when the surface is rough. So we'll proceed with activity now. Material required: a stack of books. You can see a stack of books are arranged in this way. A wooden plank. This is a wooden plank. A towel. A sheet of aluminium foil. A plastic sheet. A small lunch box. You can see a lunch box is shown. And a stopwatch. So you have understood the arrangement of how the activity need to be carried out. Procedure: stack the book and place a wooden plank as shown. Let the lunchbox slide over the surface. Note the time it takes to come to rest from here to here. You have to repeat the activity by wrapping the lunchbox with a towel, then with a sheet of aluminium foil, and then with a plastic sheet. So the conclusion will be the surface on which the lunchbox takes the maximum time to come to rest offers most friction. Here lunchbox was wrapped with towel, sheet of aluminium foil. You can carry out the same activity this way as well. You can see here a towel is being placed on the wooden plank. So the maximum time the lunchbox is going to take in order to come to rest on a particular surface will offer most friction. Next topic is types of friction. There are 3 types of friction: static friction, sliding friction, and rolling friction. You have to keep in mind that in static friction, there will be no movement of an object. Sliding friction, the object is going to slide on a surface. Rolling friction, object is going to roll on a surface. So, 3 types of friction: static, sliding, and rolling. Now we are going to study in detail about the 3 types of friction. Number 1 is static friction. You have to always keep in mind that static friction is going to have a maximum value than sliding friction and rolling friction. So we are going to see definition of static friction. Static friction is the maximum value of the frictional force between 2 surfaces which can prevent one surface from sliding over the other. So it means that static friction is not going to allow an object to move and remain stationary. It keeps the object stationary when it is placed on a surface. You can see here, cause of static friction, car is not going to slide down a hill but is going to remain stationary and will not move. It is because of the static friction, which is having a maximum value, that prevents a car from sliding down a hill when parked. Car will remain stationary, will not move because of the static friction. Static friction varies based on the force applied on the object but has a maximum value. You can see here a man is applying a force in order to move a box. Static friction is going to act in opposite direction. So, depending upon the applied force, static friction is also going to vary or change. So, when the applied force is going to overcome or is greater than the static friction, then only the object is going to move. So, when this man is going to apply more force than that of the static friction, then only this box is going to move. When this box will start moving, static friction is going to end. And what is going to start is kinetic friction or sliding friction. Kinetic is a word related to motion. So, as this box is no longer stationary and will start moving, static friction will be over, whereas its place will be taken by kinetic or sliding friction. So now we are going to take example in order to understand static friction. You already know that static friction has a maximum value. You can see here a washing machine is being shown. And this is a floor on which washing machine is standing. So, the maximum static friction between the washing machine, and a tile floor is 50 Newton. Okay. So, if we have to move the machine, what need to be done is applied force should overcome this static friction force. That is 50 N. So, if this man is applying a force of 25 Newton, is it sufficient in order to move the machine? No, it is not sufficient to move the machine, washing machine. So, static friction will still remain 25 Newton and washing machine is not going to move. So, if a man is increasing the applied force on a washing machine now to 35 Newton. Firstly, it was 25 Newton. Now the applied force has increased to 35 Newton. Still this washing machine is not going to move because static friction will also increase to 35 Newton. So, this washing machine is not going to move until and unless the force applied is greater than the maximum static frictional force, which is 50 Newton. So, applied force need to be greater than 50 Newton if washing machine need to be moved. At this point, the washing machine will start moving, that is sliding. So, once the washing machine starts sliding, there is no longer static frictional force. Reason, static frictional force doesn't allow objects to move but keep it stationary. So, once the washing machine starts sliding, it means that there is no longer a static frictional force but only sliding friction. Second type of friction is sliding friction. Sliding friction is also known as kinetic friction, that means related to motion. Here objects are going to move. So we are going to see the definition of sliding friction. Sliding or kinetic friction is the friction that results from two surfaces being pressed against each other while sliding. So you can see a box is shown. And you can see a floor is there. So, there is two surfaces, box surface and a floor surface. So, these two surfaces of box and floor are being pressed against each other when this box is going to slide. It is this friction that makes sure an object does not continue to move forever when a force has acted on it. Until and unless the force is applied, this box is going to slide. Once the applied force is not there or stop, The box is not going to slide, so it makes sure that object will not move continuously but will only move when the force is applied on it. Force is acted upon it. You already know that static friction has maximum value. So what we can say is sliding friction is less than static friction for the same material in contact with. We'll take example here now. It is easier to slide a piece of a furniture over the floor after you start moving it than it is to get it moving in the first place. We are going to take examples of sliding friction further. We have already taken example of washing machine when we were studying about the static friction. Because of static friction, washing machine was not moving but was on a stationary position. So washing machine pushed along the floor is what is example of the sliding friction. Second example is a book being slid on a table. You can see here a force is applied which will help in sliding the book on a table. Because of high magnitude of sliding friction, one prefers to roll an object on a wheel rather than dragging it along, as a rolling friction is far less. So it will be better to roll an object rather than sliding or dragging an object. So comes the third type of friction, that is a rolling friction. We are going to see rolling friction definition. Rolling friction occurs when one object rolls across other. So we will take example of rolling friction. You can see here a ball is rolling on a surface. Here the force is applied. Here the friction is there. Ball is going to roll on a surface. Same way, tire or a wheel is also going to roll on a surface. Rolling friction is the resistive force that slows down the motion of a rolling ball or a wheel. We'll take example of a suitcase. It is not easy to slide a suitcase on a floor, but if the suitcase has wheels, it will be much easier to carry the suitcase from one place to another place. So here, wheels are going to play important role in taking the suitcase from one place to another place. Rolling friction is lesser than sliding friction, and sliding friction is lesser than the static friction. We have already studied static friction is going to have maximum value and do not allow an object to move. Object remains stationary when a static friction is acting on it. So we will revise about three types of friction: static friction, sliding friction, rolling friction. Static friction is always going to oppose or resist the force between two surfaces and do not allow the motion or movement of an object. Sliding friction is going to allow the movement of an object. Rolling frictions allows very easy movement of an object rather than of sliding friction and static friction. We already know that static friction is going to have the maximum value than sliding friction and rolling friction. Rolling friction is less than sliding friction. Sliding friction is less than the static friction. Thank you.